Once you know one object-oriented programming language, learning another one becomes a lot easier. They all high level, have the same concepts, you just have to learn a syntax for that particular language. Hey YouTube, it's the test lead. And today we're talking about the best programming languages to learn as a QA automation tester or as a SDET, a software developer engineering test. Newsflash. If you want to be a automation tester or a software developer engineering test, you must know how to code. That is a simple requirement. Today, we're going to talk about the best languages for you to learn to transition to be a automation tester or a SDET. The first one on our list is Python. Python is very popular in QA because of its readability and simplicity. So really quick, what are some of the pros and cons of using Python? Pros: easy to learn, has a clean and readable syntax, extensive community support, works well for various automation tasks, offers testing frameworks like Selenium and PyTest. Now, some of the cons: slower execution compared to languages like Java. It may not be as suitable for very complex or resource-intensive projects. And if you want to start with Python, the website is here. I'll create future videos diving deeper and introducing Python, but for right now, on to our next language, Java. Java is widely used for enterprise-level applications, including testing. It's mostly known for its platform independence, making it suitable for cross-platform testing. Now, the pros. It is a strongly typed language, great performance, vast library ecosystem, well-suited for complex projects, supports testing frameworks like Selenium and TestNG. Now, some of the cons. Requires more verbose code compared to Python. Steeper learning curve for beginners. And this is the website here for Java. Fun fact, Java was the first programming language I ever knew. I actually learned Python last. Learned that within the last year or two. But because I knew Java and C# prior, picking up Python was very simple. Third on our list, we have JavaScript. JavaScript is essential for web-based automation testing, especially because it's the primary language for manipulating web elements and interactions. First, the pros. Important for browser automation, using tools like Selenium WebDriver. Lightweight and fast, widely used in web development, supports frameworks like Jasmine and Protractor. Now, some of the cons. Can be challenging for non-web automation tasks. The asynchronous nature might confuse beginners. The link for JavaScript is here. Next, we have C#. C# was actually made by Microsoft and is often used in conjunction with tools like Microsoft's Visual Studio for Windows-based application testing. For the pros, we have it's strongly typed, it integrates well with Windows environments. It supports tools like Selenium and SpecFlow for behavior-driven testing. The cons: limited cross-platform capabilities compared to Java, more specific to Windows development. Currently, I use C# every day with my company. We have a Microsoft tech stack, so we use all Microsoft products. And last but not least, we have Ruby. Ruby is a little less popular, but it still made the list. It's known for its simplicity and elegant syntax, or way of writing code. Its pros include being very readable and easy to write. It's suitable for scripting tasks. It supports the widely used automation framework, Capybara. Its cons: it's less versatile than Python or Java, limiting use outside of testing compared to other language. And like the rest of them, the website is here if you want to learn more about it. So as you can see, the best programming language to learn for QA depends on your need. We have the ones that are easy to read and write, like Python. We have platform-specific ones, like C#. We have more efficient ones for resources, like Java. Personally, I feel Python is a great starting point for people who are new to coding. And like I said in the beginning, once you know one object-oriented programming language, learning another one becomes a lot easier. They all high level have the same concepts, you just have to learn a syntax for that particular language. If you need help on your QA journey, check out my book, QA Must Know Vocabulary, as well as my course, the Manual QA Academy. Also, if you need help in your automation journey, I'll come out with a new course next year, so please subscribe. If you found this video helpful at all, please like, share, and subscribe. Any questions, comments, or concerns, leave them below. And most importantly, don't forget this, learn something new today.